When the man is on your back, life's a snare in which...
We designed this common area, you know, so that when people are in the common zone, then you're going to basically be, you know, looking right out onto all the action. That's one of the lots. There's a second lot about 200 yards away down below that is also under development, so... He and I have known each other since we were kids. Derek and I kind of backpacked around the West Coast a little bit, up to Colorado, through California, and then I found my way out to Hawaii. And him and I started game planning and business planning, you know, as to how we could convince somebody to fund us for, you know, it's quite a large project actually that we've undertaken. Our property was unique because it only has stag ferns and ohia lehua trees on it, so it's given us the opportunity. What we call landcraft. I'm in the process of putting up an eco-village of cabins that are made out of locally sourced material, the ohia trees. I've got a big resource with bamboo. I got a 20 kilowatt hour per day solar system. It's like a 5K system. We've been out here for basically about 18 months, and that's where we're at. We are, but there's a certain practicality to that as well. We've got a couple of different ways that people can come to the farm set up. We're a backpackers hostel, and people can come and they can pay $25 to $30 a night and have like a camping accommodation or like a bunk accommodation. But I also have like a resident volunteer program to where that price goes down. And so currently we've got about 10 people living on the farm and are out here helping us build the farm. But going into phase two, going into next year, I'm going to be looking to short-term volunteers, long-term residents, and we want hostel guests as well. We really want to be permaculture focused going forward, using natural materials, and finding people that want to do that as, you know, the trade with us.